So this is kind of where I dump all my offcuts off the plasma table, get them out of the shop and out of the way. And that's about 6 months worth right there. It's been about that long since I've taken them to the scrap, and I got more. So let me just show you what I got going on here this weekend. So I got my truck back here, and I'm just making some decisions on stuff to get rid of it. You know, it just, I don't know, just chasing after it. It just, I mean, there's usable stuff in this. I mean, this is a piece of half inch plate right there that's got, but you know, the keeping that big thing around just to possibly get something about 2-3 inches out of that, I don't know, it's becoming not worth it. Because if it's bigger, you know, if it's like 6-8 inches, now you're starting to get where you can get something out of it that's usable. But once it gets below that, nobody wants it. There's nothing you can get out of it, you know, that's of any real value. This thing right here, you might remember it. This used to be a welding cart, and I purpose built it for the Eastwood MIG, TIG, and plasma. And I had it all wired up so that there were outlets on it, and you know, so there weren't cords draped everywhere. And I had these crazy looking doors. I'm overlaying some footage from the video build way back before I was even in the shop, and it's kind of just been sitting and taking up space. So what I did was I just got random scraps, you know, some round bar pipe, and made some additional fixtures on it. And it was all kind of cantilevered out with no support on the front to leave it all open where you could get access to everything. So I welded a square tubing, and I ran this through the belt sander because it has a lot of rust on it. But I got to run some tubes through soon for Greg Porter, these aluminum tubes here, and I wanted to just kind of get a feel for what it was like to run some tubing through it. It ran through there no problem, you know, 36 grit is what I had on it, and it would take a few more passes to get that pitting out of there, you know, keep cranking it up. But so my goal is to get this thing out of here. It's just, it's highly unproductive, and I don't use it very much. And the really only thing I use it for is this 16 gauge. But I had it just stacked full of offcuts on top. And EcoMouse Design will be happy to know that I finally got to where I could get to these half inch plates, or these weird random offcuts. And I got another couple of them over here. So I got to cut some parts out of this here in the next couple of days for the table kit I'm working on, and I'm going to get his part cut out of it and ship to him. He's been asking me to do that for a week or two or three, or maybe a year or two or three. But so, you know, my thought is these weird cuts, I put these pipes on the back so I can stack them and they can go up really tall, and then smaller, and the same thing here with partial sheets kind of leaned in there on the side. Of course, this thing's on casters, it rolls around, still rolls pretty good even with the weight on it now. So I can get more in there, and then the little small stuff, you know, 1/4 inch, 3/8, just random offcuts and things. You can see some of them I've actually gotten other brackets out of. There's more right there. There's a 1/4 inch, some kind of a weird 1/4 inch shape up there. But I think I need to divide this one up even more, because the more you divide it up, the more you can get things stacked in here organized without building on top of each other, which is what I got over here that I'm trying to get rid of as well. I'm going to use this, but I'm going to make sure I use it in a productive way. This thing, I've mentioned it in videos, I've not touched it in about a year, and I've already actually cleaned some crap out of it so far today. But one of my mistakes is I don't nest very well, and I kind of just randomly get pieces out of it. And when you got holes in it and you slot it back in there, they lock together, and then you can't get it out easily, you know. And there's just stuff buried under there that some of it needs to be taken to scrap. I mean, there's a lot in here that's barely got any usable areas in it that I've just, you know, been holding on to for dear life that need to go. So my goal is to get this completely cleaned off and don't use this for a bunch of crap, you know. So what I did was I took this table that you guys have been seeing, you know, for a long time, just collecting trash and random boxes and things like that. And now it may look crooked on camera, but it's probably just the angle I'm shooting it at, because there's no way that I got any of these boards in there crooked. It's just impossible. But seriously, I put all these 1x3 strapping in here and attached them to the 2x4 support that supporting the top, you know, and just kind of nailed it in from each side. Well, those were all, you know, kind of bent and, you know, not in there straight. And these boards are not straight. So anyway, it's not exactly square. But what you see is there's a bunch of little slots right here on purpose for sheets to slip into. So you can get 3, 4, 5 in there, depending on how thick they are, and not get it all jammed up. You can easily pull it out, see what it is, without it just, once you get something this wide and you get a bunch of stuff in there, it leans one way or the other and locks it all in, and you, without dragging all that out to get to something underneath, you're not using it. Bottom line is, I haven't used this in about a year. Nothing. I mean, I've not touched it. I don't even look at it. I just walk right by, and it's just huge, taking up a bunch of mess. So anyway, I picked these up a while back. The local convenience store was giving them away. They were re-inventorying or doing something, and I should have gotten more of them. I just grabbed a few. I didn't know what I might need them for. I should have grabbed a bunch more. But so, you know, I've got these for smaller parts, like things like that, you know, thicker materials that are smaller that I might want to keep. And then what I was thinking about doing is, you know, coming up with some kits of offcuts. And this is kind of what I got right now, or what I was thinking, you know, something like that that would go in a flat rate box. You got a couple of skull gussets. You got a piece of a quarter inch plate there. Yeah, it's got some holes drilled in it, but there's a bunch of usable space. 2 half-inch thick brackets, some stainless if you wanted to practice your stainless welding, and some little coupons there. And same thing, another little pile. You know, so I was thinking about, this would go in a flat rate box. I could sell this for like $20 plus the $13 for the flat rate box. So you're looking at like $33 for something like that. So a set of these web gusset bookshelves, and I got videos on those shelves. I've made a few out of it, but you could use it as gussets, you know, for any kind of a frame that you're building or whatever you wanted. But I got a whole box of it here. So I was just thinking about, you know, just getting rid of it. It's been sitting here for 2 years. I cut this out of some excess plate, and I think I've had a couple people here and there, you know, buy it. And but it's not, let me just say, it's not a hot seller. But I don't really promote that stuff. A lot of people don't really know that it's there. So EcoMouse Design, I told him I was going to repurpose this, and he had sent me over a look at, you know, possibly what he would do. And this is different than what he did, but one of his ideas was to take some plumbing pipe and stagger it in there like that. And you could use your, you know, you could put flat bar or, you know, whatever you can fit in that 3-inch diameter pipe, without getting it stacked up on top of each other where you can still get to it easily. So round bar, you know, I really want to use this just for offcuts though. And I don't, you know, have a lot of tubing and round offcuts that are of any notice. So, you know, I got lots of empty spaces, but I'm about to go through all this, and it's either going to get cut down to a size that'll fit in this and the rest scrapped, or just scrapped. You know, I mean, there's just so much stuff. It's probably usable. You know, there's more coupons in here. So let me know what you guys think about this idea. I'm going to just stick it out there and see if I get any hits on it. If you go to my website, RamseyCustoms.com, and go to the tools area, you're going to see something called scrap metal grab bag. It's going to be $33 total, including shipping, coming flat rate. And, you know, and it's just going to be what it's going to be. I mean, the cost of the metal is nothing to me. I've already likely gotten my profit out of whatever that came out of. It's really just the hassle of boxing it. And the minute people start going, well, you know, I don't want the skulls, I want this, it's just not worth it. You know, I can't chase after, you know, $15 and $20. And, you know, and I'm not trying to say that I wouldn't help somebody out. You know, I mean, if you're in some kind of a real jam, and I mean, I have done that in the past. I just can't make a business out of doing that, you know, and I gotta do the jobs that make money. So quick update on this. Oh, and so what my long-term plan here is to get rid of this thing here. And what I'm going to do I'm trying to make use of storage space that I've never made use of. One is all that space under that. You can see I've just started sliding a few sheets in here. Like, you know, this is a nice usable section. And I got stacks of it everywhere. It just, if you don't manage it and deal with it, it just piles up on you. I got lots of stuff. And I gotta quit leaving these little hangers like this, because when you get two in there together that have like this, they get locked. And you, when you start to pull one, it all wants to come out. And so anyway, my goal, my plan here, let me just show you real quick what I'm after, what I'm trying to do, is I'm gonna move this table right here once I get this all organized where this table is. Or one way or the other, I'm gonna have both tables in line with each other. You can see I've already moved. I've made space over there and moved those cabinets, which were right here. Moved those over here. So I'm gonna take that table right there and put it in line with this one coming this way. Now this normally I have over here in my fabrication area. I keep both of them all, you know, kind of in here together. So that's my plan. And that would open all this up right in this area right here. So this will be wide open. And my plan with that is to take my bandsaw area and move it running this way right here. So it would be just on the other side of my tables, or behind my tables from me. And then take that vertical bandsaw and move it over here. Because I'm cleaning that out, I'm getting rid of that. That's gonna open all that space up. And I'm moving that rack up here in the corner, you know, just, I'm not exactly sure how or where yet, but somewhere over there. And I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with those toolboxes. I might move them, I might, you know, I'm not sure quite yet. But what I'm trying to do is clear out this entire area back over here to make room for another machine that I'm trying to get. And it's proven to be difficult, a laser tube cutting machine. And I've mentioned it in the video, but it's a fiber laser, you know, tube cutter. If you guys have seen precisionlaser.com, I think it is, the ones that make the kits, you know. I mean, you could do anything with tubing with it, round, square, rectangle, and do any kind of design in the tubing that you want, you know, coped for notching for roll bars, I mean, whatever, anything. So, you know, I want to get that and make room for it. And it needs quite a bit of space, actually, because it's a good size machine. And that would give access, you know, to come in the door here and get access to it. So, and that would also let me clean up this corner and all these offcuts that are back here that I rarely ever use. And that crap back there, just get all this cleaned up. So anyway, guys, that's what's going on. I know I'm rambling a lot. I'm not sure what all you guys think about it. You guys keep seeing the new table. I keep going around it. It's actually, I've had some difficulty here. And I've just used it once and I've not used it again. It's what it is this Thermal Dynamics cutter. It's a brand new, it's been out for a year, but I'm using this Thermal Dynamics cutter in conjunction with the Thermal Dynamics CNC controller, iCNC. It's known to be a really solid platform. This is. But it is having some difficulties communicating with their own cutter. And Thermal Dynamics sent an engineer on site to TrueCut this week for 3 days, because TrueCut was kind of trying to shift away from their own internal controller and Hypertherm over to a integrated Thermal Dynamics controller and cutter all in one, and go with that as a standard. And this is a prototype table. It's the very first one. So, you know, they're working on it. They're working on trying to get the bugs worked out of it. But in the meantime, TrueCut is getting me another PowerMax 85 Hypertherm unit to go back with this table, which will, you know, work well with that, no problem. It's just weird how this is Thermal Dynamics and the controller is, but yet it seems like Thermal Dynamics hasn't tested it. But I had a lot of problems with it when I tried to cut this out. You can see how much it's warped up this sheet here. It just was not behaving well. I made a video, I showed it running, I showed it doing some cutting, but what I didn't show was the torchite control and how just erratic it is. Just, you know, jumping up and down and moving up real high and randomly, you know, like for no real reason. But as far as like the controller running the table and everything, oh man, this thing is freaking sweet. And I'm gonna do, when I get it up and running for good, I'll do a full walk around and talk about some really cool features on this one that my other table didn't have. And with this controller, just some, you know, of course the live spindle on it for drilling and other things I have planned for it that runs off air. And I made this janky G3 logo. This is called the G Generation 3 machine. This is their third generation. And I thought it might be cool to have some kind of a G3 logo, and it's kind of crappy looking. Part of it's, the reason it's crappy is because the cuts aren't that great. But part of it is just what I designed this. See, like right here, if you see this little, that would be where it like jumped up and down. It had an erratic move. And it's got little areas like that kind of all around on it. And it's kind of subtle. You wouldn't think anything about it, but I'm used to having my machine run really good and make beautiful cuts. And for the most part, you know, occasionally have a little hiccup or something, but like in general, it ran really smooth, my old table true cut machine. So anyway, guys, just a weekend Sunday update, trying to get some organization going here, trying to do some rearranging, trying to get rid of some stuff I don't need. And I really want to probably sell these two right here as well. I bought this brand new for $2,500. It's a 12-inch combo unit. It does joining and planing in the same unit. I've used it like one or two times, and it looks like it's been used more than that, but it's really because it's just sitting in here collecting dust. I mean, it really has only been used about two times. You've probably almost never seen it in the video. And I made a little roll around stand for it so you can roll it around and probably sell that too. I do use that occasionally, but not that much. I mean, maybe three times a year do I use it, and it usually just sits here and collects dust. And I'd like to just get this space back and clear up this whole corner. I don't like clutter. I mean, yeah, you might say, oh, you don't, huh? But it's annoying. It's frustrating, you know. One of the things I need to do is move this sander back now that I have it running. I've used it a bunch. Here's something that went through it. It just does a beautiful job. You know, this is some 5052 90 thousandths aluminum, and that's one pass through on each side. It's 36 grit. I probably will put a finer grit belt on it for my main production work once I, you know, kind of get it. Once I get back to making metal art, I've got 15 flags to make for a company, and I've already got my first order for a 5x10 sign, 5 feet by 10 feet. And I've got it designed, it's ready to go. The aluminum's gonna be here soon. I gotta make a frame for the back of it because it's so big, it's gonna have a square tubing frame. So yeah, I mean, I got plenty of work keeping me busy, and I'll just be happy to get more organized so I can be productive and not be tripping over, you know, just, I mean, look at this. For about 3 months, I had that right there stacked up against this, and then I would have to use this machine, and so I would move it over here and stack it right there, and I'd be like, whoa, I need to cut something, and I have to move it back over there. It's just, it's madness. It's ridiculous, you know? And if you just keep ignoring it and staying busy working and with your head down and you don't have a good plan for managing your offcuts, it'll get out of hand in a hurry. And some of you probably are looking at this thinking, well, my shop is a big mess compared to that. I don't work well when it's messy. I really, you know, you can kind of mask it for a while and kind of shove some things in corners, but at some point it catches up to you if you don't have a plan for it. But one of my plans is to manage how I do the sheets and in CAD and CAM, and have instead of using individual programs and cutting out, you know, individual things and laying a sheet up, I'm gonna batch it more. You know, I got a real bad habit of, you know, cutting two things out of a sheet and then getting that sheet off the table because I need to put quarter inch on there. And I'm going to manage it better in my CAD and my CAM so that the sheet is kept up with. And when I put my next part up there, you know, because I can orient the sheet and home this machine, and it'll always know right where it is. And so I could take the sheet down when I get ready to put, you know, let's say aluminum back on there. It'll already know what's been cut out, and it'll go to the next open spot because that's how I'm going to nest it. And I'm just going to process the sheets and not end up with this. And I'm going to get rid of stuff that's smaller than something that's not really usable. And anything that's real small, you know, I'll probably cut coupons out of it, just welding coupons, and continue to do the grab bag thing, assuming people want it, you know, and just stack them in these trays, and then maybe come up with some other kind of kits, you know, that can be done out of sheet metal that people might want to do as DIY projects or whatever. People that, you know, don't have plasma tables and want to do something cool, you know, logos, or you could do names, or you know, anything really. So all right, guys, it's been 20 minute video. I'm sorry I've made a video this long. I just figured I'd show you guys what was going on in here, and I just about got this done. So let me know what you think about all the organization. Oh, one last thing. I started to tell you a couple of different times what my plan is for this. So I got all this space under the plasma table, and I made this for 4x8 sheets. But look, I got a 1/4-inch plate stacked on top of a 1/2-inch plate. What if I need that 1/2-inch plate? You know, and not only that, I had a bunch stacked up even more on top of this, and it just became, you know, a pain in the butt to deal with it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this whole thing apart and get rid of the trailer. I'm going to just sell it locally on Facebook Marketplace. It's a Harbor Freight, you know, like $300-$400 kit trailer. And I built this framing on top of it when I first got in the shop. But all these layers are, you know, they got runners underneath them. It's 2x2 14 gauge square tubing. And I'm going to make like a pallet system, like a pallet changer, but a little less automated than the fancy CNC lasers have. And they're going to go under that. And I'm going to mount skateboard wheels probably under the bottom of them and have them recessed up in there so they roll on skateboards. And they'll roll in and out from underneath the table on the frame that I'll build. So I'm going to probably do 4 different thicknesses. So like 16 gauge sheet metal, 1/8-inch, 1/4-inch, and aluminum, and have brand new sheets of each under there. And if I need to, and then on below the lower section here, I'm going to get one of those Harbor Freight motorcycle lifts. So I can roll the motorcycle lift out and then roll out one of these pallets with new sheets on it, and then use my, you know, like an air over hydraulic cylinder on the motorcycle lift to lift it up to the table height, and then push the sheet off onto the table, and be able to utilize all that and get this right here out of here. This has just been in the way. I don't use it. It just collects. I've already unloaded a bunch, but you can see just like, you know, I've already unloaded some of those 3/8 offcuts are there and gotten them onto this. So that's my plan. That's going to be a little bit down the road, you know, maybe another month or so before I can get half time. I got to get some work done, some real customer work done. As soon as I get my Hypertherm 85, which should be in a couple of days, then I'll be wide open back cutting again. And all these jobs, I got 15 flags with a corporate logo on them to go out to a company. It's a pretty big job for me. But not really that big, you know. It's going to be my first production job that I get to cut, you know, at a higher speed than I normally do, and then run them through the sander to do all the prep. And then it's mask and paint, you know, a little bit of artistic design with a grinder. But all the hand grinding and stuff that I used to do to prep them for paint, that's gone. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm really looking forward to seeing, knocking that job out. It's about a $3,000 job, so... All right, guys. See ya.